May 21st, 2019. This is the fourth installment and the third set of tools that we would need if we're going to try to find a cure. And I'm not saying there is, but if there was, this might be one of the possibilities that might be useful. There was a man in the late 80s and early 90s named Dr. Patrick Carnes. He was the very first guy to coin the phrase sex addiction. And he wrote it in his doctoral thesis, Out of the Shadows. And it became a hugely successful program that went throughout the world and helped a lot of people. But one of the things that he said was, there's a 400% greater chance that you will be a sex addict if you were abused as a child. Now, most of this recording is going to be going to people who have PMO, porn, masturbation, and orgasm. But there are other addictions. But this is mostly to that. So if there's a 400% greater chance that you'll be addicted to porn and masturbation if you're abused as a child. And this is a really sensitive issue because people get really defensive. One of the salient characteristics of a victim is to protect the assailant. Because if you say that that didn't happen, then you don't have to feel the sadness and hurt of you being hurt. And so we just deny it. But here are the six. Here's how you know. If there was genital contact with you or an adult before you were 18, or with someone who's an adult before you were 18 years old, that's sexual abuse. Also sexual innuendo, double entendre, sexualized humor, hearing your parents have sex in the other room, people saying inappropriate things, all that is sexual abuse. It's just sexual abuse. Physical abuse. Physical abuse is really obvious. Contusions, bruises, cuts, but also, and it's divided here in America. They still use corporal punishment. I personally believe striking a child for any reason is abuse. For me, that's what I believe. So there's physical abuse, and I certainly suffered a great deal of that. And a lot of people say, well, you know, my father, he liked me. He just hit me with a belt every now and then. You know, that's what we call denial. So there's physical abuse. There's emotional abuse. That means shaming someone. You're no good. You'll never amount to anything. Or blaming. It's all your fault. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be like this. Are controlling and just try to micromanage somebody and get them to do everything that you want so that you feel safe. Shaming, blaming, and controlling is the definition of emotional abuse. Emotional neglect, that's the fourth one. And that's if there's not somebody in your life who talks about how they feel and say, you know, I'm feeling kind of tired, I'm feeling kind of needy, I'm feeling sad, I'm feeling a little worn out. And this is why, you know, I only got 4 hours of sleep last night. I'm challenged in this particular relationship and I'm feeling kind of burdened by that. If they can't talk about their feelings and share about why, then you were emotionally neglected. You were just left alone and you didn't know as a child that you had feelings and that they were important so that people could connect to them. That's called emotional neglect. Verbal abuse. What verbal abuse is any kind of obscenity or profanity expressed in anger. God damn, kid, you motherfucker. Stuff like that. If you heard that all day, you were being verbally abused. So we've got, and then the one that's least, the least likely, especially in America, is physical neglect. That means if you didn't have clothes or shelter or food, and that was the litmus test that I grew up with. Look, you got food, clothes, and shelter. What are you complaining about? If you haven't got those three things, you're being physically neglected. So if any of those, physical neglect, physical abuse, emotional neglect, emotional abuse, sexual abuse, or verbal abuse happened to you, then there's a 400% greater chance that you're sitting here addicted to porn right this minute. Patrick Carnes said there's a 97% of us were just emotionally abused. That leaves out the other five types. So this is a tough video. This is one that really makes people's stomach gurgle because it's hard to think about and hard to feel and to look at. But if there were a cure, and I'm not saying there is, if there were, one of the things it would include is eradicating child abuse from potential sex acts when we're children. Stop the abuse of any of the six types. Or if we're adults and already have it, to go back and deal with it and heal from those victimhood issues. All right, got a couple more tools to go. See you in a minute.